Hey everyone, just wanted to make a short and sweet video about LinkedIn headlines, which I know can trip a lot of people up. A question I had gotten during the last talk was, you know, what do you make your headline if you either were laid off or you don't have a job? The good news is I've never actually advocated to have a LinkedIn headline that is your position title. You know, there's so much flexibility here. So I just want to get y'all's creative juices flowing, let you know what you can do instead of whatever position title you had in the past. So I'm going to pull up a little screen share real quick. Okay. This is from one of my talks I give on LinkedIn, and I'll kind of adjust it here to the situation. So in my opinion, the LinkedIn headline is one of the most important parts of your LinkedIn profile. And the reason I say that is just because oftentimes it's the first thing that people see when they pop open your LinkedIn profile. And I think even when someone's searching for candidates via LinkedIn, the two things that they're going to see are your headline and your picture. So even before opening up that profile. So I would recommend just making sure that A, you have a really solid picture taken. You can even take one with an iPhone, just with good lighting. And you spend some time getting a really nice, concise headline. Now, that's why. So the three things I would tell you to focus on for your headline are, number one, make sure that you really grab people's attention and that you're captivating. So I recommend, you know, thinking really closely about what would draw someone in if they're searching for their ideal candidate. I also say it should be forward seeking. So really pay attention to the positions you're applying for, not necessarily where you've been in your past. This is some commonly given advice for job seekers, and I really stand by it when it comes to your LinkedIn headline. So if you are making a transition, really try to pay close attention to the job you're applying for, not necessarily what you've done in the past. This is going to help make sure you're targeted and really locked in to some of the jobs that you're applying for. And lastly, and this is where the advice comes in for people who have been laid off, make it keyword driven to your industry. So a tip for something that you could easily do for coming up with a good LinkedIn headline is come up with three key phrases to set yourself apart. Those three key phrases are captivating and forward seeking. And these are three things that can even be picked up as keywords when someone's searching for you. I believe that the About Me section and the summary are two of the best sections or two of the best spots to capture those keywords. So it takes a little bit of digging. It's some things that we've covered before in the last talk and something that we're going to cover in the talk tomorrow, which is April 7th, are just how to get targeted and figure out really where you're applying. So I recommend figuring out what some key phrases are to include. Pulling open an example, this is a client I wrote for a long time ago who, like you, we chose not to go with this position title because you are not just the job you're working at right now. This person was heavily involved with business analysis and process improvement. Those were the two things that he was really good at. And he was essentially applying for jobs that were within nonprofit. He wanted to be a manager. So we made that keyword nonprofit management. You can see it's really easy to space out these keywords. I just put in a spacer in between each one of these keywords. And those are the big three that I discovered for him. It's up to you to discover what the three keywords are for you. Test it out, try it out. And I think you will be on your way to having a good LinkedIn headline. There is another way to get a headline, but this is just the easiest and quickest thing I can tell you to do today to come up with a good headline. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm here for you.